Hi guys, we've been invited to show you how to make films with this. This is a Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus, but you can do it with every touchscreen phone you've got. To do it properly, we'll work on a special character who's an everyday's anti-hero. His name is Cypher. So now let's talk about camera settings. If you're using DSLR or DSLM camera, you should already know that when you set the aperture, the lower is the value, the brighter the image, as more light comes into the lens. Going further, setting the aperture high, in this case 22 because it's sunny outside, will darken the image because of less light coming into the sensor. Also, remember that the lower aperture will give you more background blur and higher will give a sharper image overall. It's important if you want to separate your character from the background, you will use low value of aperture. Using your pocket cameras, you have to keep your screen as clean as possible. So, to have a clear vision on what you're recording. Also, keep your lens as clean as possible, so grab a microfiber towel and wipe it clean. Keep in mind that having the brightness up will give you clear vision on bright environment, but remember, check if your device is not getting too hot. In this case, it was so sunny outside that you can see a reflection of me, even if I set the brightness at max value. Remember to keep your ratio settings right for your kind of film. In Galaxy S10 we've got full, that extends the screen, we've got 1:1, a square image, and the most common ratio, 16:9. You will also meet ratios like 4:3, but as I said, it depends on what you're recording right now. Most of the time, 16:9 will do. You shouldn't really use a flashlight because most of the time it doesn't really give us what we are looking for. The light is hard and so give us a hard shadow. Even if you're recording dark scenery, you shouldn't really use it. Remember that the light sensors in your phones are small, so the more light they get, will give you the better image quality. Speaking of image quality, let's get into recording settings. We've got variety of settings here, but the most important ones for you now are ratio, frames per second, and resolution. Most of the time, available settings depends on what brand you have. You can see that we have a 4K resolution here, but remember that higher resolution doesn't really give you more quality. Sometimes it will be just harder to edit, so keep that in mind. For example, Full HD image from DSLR camera will always be better than 4K image from phone, for example. Some of your phones will have a stabilization helper. In this case, it's called Super Steady. It's useful because how it works is that it blends frames of your footage and cuts them, so they fall smoother. But that lowers your image quality and as you can see, it gives us a fisheye effect. So that's not really what we want most of the time. Now, in like every touchscreen phone, you've got the option to set the focus by tapping on a part of the frame. Most of the time you just tap on your subject and it just sets the focus on them, but you can tap on the sky in this case, so the sharpness goes there and the rest of the image gets darker because your phone wants to keep your selected subject the most detailed part of the image. It's important that you tap before the take so your device knows that this is your subject and if it moves, the autofocus will do its job. Always remember that every style of showing your character says different things and gets your viewer to react specifically. If you want to show your character as important in your story, you have to use close-up takes like medium shot or mid shot. If you want to show emotions of your character, you have to use close-up. And finally, things that makes film cinematic is extreme close-up takes. They are used to show very important details like eye, ring or lip moving. This take style helps to get your viewer's attention into the story. It lets the viewers feel emotions of your character. As you can see, guys, during shooting, all the time my knees are bent. It helps to control and stabilize footage. Also, important thing is the way of holding your phone. Look that I'm holding it with both hands. That helps to control camera and isolate unwanted shakes or movements in shot. There you have examples of a take with this technique and without. At last, we'd like to show you the difference between image taken on gimbal, a stabilization device, and a take made by hand with correct technique. We hope that with this tutorial, you will be able to get the most out of your pocket cameras. And the next episode will teach you how to use your footage in editing. So, see ya!